Today, we will create a dashboard displaying all javelin throws in Olympic Games that won gold medals. We will create the dataset using AI. You can use tools like Gemini or ChatGPT. Then we will create this dashboard and animate it using the Play Axis visual. Finally, we will upload this dashboard to Power BI service and see how it works there. So let's start our tutorial. We will use this data in Excel file and also show you how to create datasets using AI. You can create similar datasets using any AI application such as ChatGPT or Gemini. Let's ask Gemini to create this dataset in tabular form by entering instructions in the prompt. It takes few seconds for Gemini to generate our desired data in tabular form. Some of the values such as distances are missing. We can rephrase our question to make it more understandable for AI. Now hopefully we will get the entire information just as we want. Great, this is how you can get information you want using AI, exactly in the format you want, instead of researching for the information all around the internet. However, for more sensitive information, always verify the information from reliable sources. Go to Data Group and click on Excel Workbook button. Open the Javelin dataset file. In the Navigator window, select the sheet containing the data of Olympics javelin throws. And click on the Load button. After the data is loaded, it will be available in the data pane at the right side of the screen. And from here you can use this data in your reports and dashboards. Now, using the text box visual, add an appropriate title to your dashboard. For our first visual, let's add a gauge visual and place it at the top left corner of our dashboard. Now, let's add the distance field to the value area of the gauge chart aggregated as maximum, because we want to display the longest throw in the Olympics. The longest throw is 92.97 meters, made in 2024 Paris Olympics. The gauge shows the value in the middle, which does not reflect the true intensity of the value. We need to set the minimum and maximum values of the gauge visuals as well. Let's see the minimum and maximum distance from the distance column. I guess 50 and 100 are better for minimum and maximum values. Add a measure to your data pane and set its value to 50. We will use this measure for the minimum value in the gauge visual. Now, add another measure and set its value to 100. We will use this measure for the maximum value in the gauge visual. Now, add both measures to the minimum and maximum areas of the gauge visual. Great! Now we will be able to see the true intensity of the throw distance. To display further information of top athlete, add a multi-row card and place it next to the gauge visual. Now, add the year, country, athlete, and distance fields to the multi-row card visual. Add the distance field to the filters pane. Select top N from the filter type. And in the show items, enter top 1. In the by value, add the distance field again and select maximum instead of sum. Now apply the filter to see the top athlete by throw distance in the multi-row card. Next, add a line chart visual to your dashboard and place it at the bottom left corner of the screen. Add the year field to x-axis and distance field to the y-axis of the line chart visual. Now we can see the historical data of all throws that won gold in Olympics. Add a bar chart visual to the dashboard and place it next to the line chart. Add the year field to the y-axis and distance field to the x-axis of the bar chart visual. Change the distance field to maximum to show longest throw of each country, as some countries have multiple gold medal wins in Olympics. Our dashboard is now almost complete. Select all visuals and add visual borders and rounded corners to make your dashboard more visually appealing. Select the multi-row card and in the Format tab, click on the Edit Interactions button. Now, disable interactions with all other visuals. Our dashboard is now complete. However, to make it more interesting, we can add animation to this dashboard. To do that, we need to add the Play Axis visual to our dashboard. We can add one from the internet or from a visual file if we have one. Add this visual to your dashboard and place it at the top of the page. Go to its format settings and turn off its title and caption. Then turn on visual borders and rounded corners, matching the borders of existing visuals on your report. Now, let's click on the play button and see what happens. It is animating single year data at a time. To correct this, go to the format settings and turn on the cumulative animation setting. Now we should see the entire historical data in line chart. Our animation is working perfectly. We can change the interaction of play axis with bar chart to add each bar one by one as they win their gold medal. You can select interaction based on your own liking. Publishing a Power BI report is very simple. You just have to be signed in. Then you have to just click on the Publish button here. Save the changes, and select the workplace to upload the file to Power BI service. Now, open the Power BI service page and go to the workplace where you have uploaded the file. And here we have our file. You can open this file in the browser and play it in the same way you did in your Power BI desktop application. And with this, we end our tutorial. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for more insightful tutorials and updates.